And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Nocturne Mistwraiths. It's going to be our first deck today. We have four pretty cool decks that we have not played yet on stream before, so four brand new decks. Basically, what we did for all four of these decks is I went over to the leaderboard. There's this new thing on Master's Rank here that if you go over to the leaderboard, you can go over to anybody you want and you click like inspect deck and you just kind of see just a recent deck that they've played. And so I just did that and just found four unique decks that I wanted to play today. So that's where all of our decks for today have come from. This one's gonna be just a bunch of Mistwraiths. We're gonna be going with all Shadow Isles, 40 cards. I should have written down like the user that had these if I would have thought about it, but I didn't think about it to like give them a little credit. So I'm sorry about that. Anyway, yeah, so we're going to be playing a Mistwraith deck, a Risen Mist deck, with all sorts of Mist cards. We even have Mist Call. I thought that was kind of cool. So, like, you know, it's Mistwraith and Risen Mist and Wraith Caller, you know, like, that summon Mistwraiths. But then if you just, you know, like, do, like, I don't know if they just did, like, a search for, like, the word Mist, and they're like, oh, Mist Call. We got to play three of those also. So we're going to try Mist Call to bring back Mistwraiths as well. And then we even have like two atrocities at the top end. You know, maybe we make these like 7, 8, 9, 10 power Mistwraiths. And then we can have atrocities as well. And of course, Stalking Shadows. Only two Glimpse Beyonds help find those. Lots and lots of fearsome stuff. You know, we got Frenzied Skitter in here as well. With the Arachnoid Horror, Stygian Onlooker. So lots of fearsome. And then of course, Nocturne doing its thing, being all fearsome. So that's our deck. We're going to call this Nocturne Mistwraiths. We're going to go play five games over in Ranked. Let's see how we do with these Mistwraiths. Ooh. All right, so their deck doesn't usually have a lot of blockers for Fearsome. So Fearsome could be pretty good. We're going to get rid of the Glimpse Beyond and the Doom Beast. With the Doom Beast, you know, like, doesn't, it's not a Fearsome attacker. Okay, here we go. While we could play the Onlooker on turn one, I kind of feel like we wait and play it on turn three. It's a big responsibility to shepherd stock. All right, good. I'm really glad that we waited. Turn three, we can play Arachnoid Horror and then Stygian Onlooker.
Come closer. I don't bite. They grow up so fast.
Let's get fearsome.
Caring for the stars shows their true potential. I can't wait to see them when they're all grown up. We could use a bite.
We don't want to see Pale Cascade, of course. And so they have it. It's like their only card to be able to block fearsome things.
You are better than this. So young.
All right, let's go Wraith Caller. And then next turn, what, Mistwraith and Frenzied Skitter, maybe?
By starlight.
Okay.
Live with purpose.
Perfectly fine with those things dying. Gonna quite kill them right now. Oh, I guess. Oh, right. The Star Shepherd grows. Forgot about that. That thing's gonna be a blocker.
We look after our own.
Okay. So I think it's worth it to attack. Yeah, I think attacking's worth it. We'll be able to get a good block with the Stellicorn. The 5/2 can block something else if they want.
Please don't hurt them.
And then, you know, like.
Osu, help! Please don't hurt them.
Yeah, that resplendent Stellicorn. That's awesome here for this matchup, right? Like, that's something you really don't see very often. That's kind of how my luck is, right? Like, I just have, like, this random card that's just absolutely amazing for this matchup. It gives them a blocker they don't normally have. It does some healing, and also, you know, heals the Nexus 3. So that was a good card for them. So I guess I'm going Stalking Shadows plus Doombeast. Stars fall. I think. Don't like that shakedown. The first shakedown was okay. I do not like that one.
By the power of the stars. Live with purpose.
I know I could block the Soraka, but I don't know. It doesn't really feel that worth it. Next turn, we're going to have 9 total mana, which is pretty unfortunate. It costs 10 to go Risen Mist and Skitterer.
I will find the goodness in you, River King.
Hope only provides temporary sustenance, child. There's a will, there's a meal.
Okay, so that's better. So I can have one Frenzied Skitter, Mistwraith, and Risen Mist. Nocturne wouldn't be bad of, like, giving this vulnerable so that my my other things that aren't fearsome could challenge. But it's probably better to be able to play Skitter and Risen Mist together.
Put me in, Tommy boy!
Oh, I'll be happy to accommodate.
No blocker. Bad.
Allow me a small save.
I think it's better to try to have, like, these things, you know, trade with, like, even though they can block with the 1-6 and block here, I want to try to trade with the Boxtopus with these things and not have the Boxtopus challenge fearsome. So we're going to need another turn. And I found another Pale Cascade. Oh, I didn't think we were losing this game, but just this matchup, whenever we first started this matchup, but they've really had a lot of great things. Okay, that's not so bad. I'm surprised they didn't block the Fearsome, but I'm glad they didn't.
Close your eyes.
That's going to be a blocker for Fearsome. I didn't expect them to have so many things that get to block Fearsome. And having the Stellicorn.
Be at peace.
Let's go, Osu.
Take heart. Live with purpose.
Cool. Got rid of that. So basically that Mist Call is not going to do anything else besides that.
Good to see you too.
So we want something that's fearsome that costs 2 or less mana. Or a spell. I guess our very best draw would be Stalking Shadows that hits the 1 mana 4-1. That'd be our very best draw. Okay, that's good. They're not playing the Acquire Taste, so that's good. Stalking Shadows? Okay, well, we got the 1 mana 4-1. So let's lead with this. The other two have Nightfall.
Excuse my impertinence.
But still, they could have, you know, could have potentially taken this other thing last turn also. Alright, so that's seven Fearsome. They've already played two Pill Cascades. This is gonna be close.
The Star Child. I'll clear a path.
That does not help.
Good to see you too, Finn.
Bayou Brunch. That levels up the Tom Kench, but with that other minus one, it should only have two power.
The Star Child. Here I come.
Good to see you too, Finn.
Yeah, that thing only has two power also. So it doesn't look like they'll be able to block any of these. There we go, GG's. Alright, got the win, 1-0. Good win. Alright, looks like we're playing against Scouts with Lucian. Lucian Scouts. Stalking Shadows is good, but kind of slow. I think that we want to try to get out ahead early. None of these help us really get out ahead early, but I kind of want to keep Stalking Shadows, though, because it's just such a strong card. I guess I'll keep it. But we could also get a mulligan like this. Oh my gosh. Well, this is just the worst case scenario. That's kind of how it's been. Okay. Yeah, we'll just play the Mistwraith. That's probably better than casting Stalking Shadows. We can attack for two.
Push back the darkness.
I could miscall. Right, like have, you know, these challenge, my thing dies, I miscall. Is that better than Stalking Shadows? No, I'm gonna Stalking Shadows and try to get another blocker. Is she an onlooker? Frenzy Skitter just costs too much. Warwind just keeps them from attacking with the Cythria. Like, basically keeps them from attacking with both of these, right? Like, save some life.
No room for doubt.
Okay. This saves five life.
Keep quiet.
Ooh, got pretty lucky. We got the allegiance. Hit that.
They're as good as dead.
You're adorable when you're angry.
Alright, so I'm thinking I kind of have to just kill them next turn.
These guys again.
Don't really know exactly how this is going to work. I definitely do not like seeing the Screeching Dragon, of course, because that's just another thing they can block. I don't know, I didn't build the deck list, so I was like, why not Chronicler of Ruin? I would assume because there's already too many 4-mana cards. Like, you already have Wraithcaller and Nocturne, and the 4-mana burst spell. There's already so many 4-mana cards, I just don't think the Chronicler of Ruin really fits in here.
There's nothing to fear.
I'll defend these forests to the end.
Dang. Yeah, they had a great hand. They They really did.
Won't get away this time.
Well, this isn't really that good of an attack for me.
Stay back.
But I mean, might as well, like, instead of letting them... instead of trying to work on, like, blocking... Actually, I'm just dead here, because then Lucian... Because the Screeching Dragon lets them attack again. Yeah, I'm just dead. Great hand for them, GG's. Alright, one and one. Let's see what we got. These hands... Not very good at curving out. Not very good at that. Guess I'm casting Stalking Shadows this turn.
A drop of kindness creates many ripples.
Cool. Well, that's good.
Got the goods.
We mustn't linger.
This looks like a day where we're gonna have no luck, doesn't it? Why would you? Why would they not play the Vi? I don't know why they passed. I was really considering passing, and obviously I wish I did. Like instead of playing the Doom Beast, like whenever they pass with the 5 mana, when they have like the 2 champions that cost 5, that was a consideration for sure. Playing Vile Feast. Don't really understand. The thing I'm thinking about doing is playing Vile Feast and then using Glimpse Beyond on the Vile Feast on like the Spiderling. But you know, they can have something, you know, they can have like a Mystic Shot that kills it. Why should we have Vile Feast in this deck? Yeah, so I could play the Nocturne and just make the Vi vulnerable right now, but then we don't get like the -1/-0 bonus. This is just ugly.
I know what lurks in the shadows.
The light of my star warms the heavens.
1 and 2.
By a thread.
And how we, like, we just haven't been curving out at all either. Like, that Vile Feast needs to just be another unit. We can't miss on Stalking Shadows, and we can't just, like, like Vile Feast and Miskull, those cards look embarrassing. This deck needs another one drop. I played Draven Ezreal months ago. I haven't played it any time recently.
I pull the strings.
Alright, this is at least a little bit more respectable. We have a 2-mana card and a 3-mana card, or you know, like two. We have two cards that cost 3 or less, at least. At least a little bit respectable. Wow.
A tribute to the Spider God.
Okay, well, Vile Feast did something. That's an upgrade. Got to do something with Vile Feast.
Mother Moon, guide me. Skitter out from the darkness. Must we fight?
Not too bad. Yeah, we can refill our hand with these talking shadows, hopefully.
Night flowers upon my blade.
Hopefully.
They grow up so fast. Find your own light within the darkness.
That's too bad. So we potentially had a leveled up Elise.
Find your path in the dark and follow no false light.
Diana's really good.
I cannot turn back. Face your heretic.
What?
Forgive me. So young. Now you've gone and upset it.
I'm going to try to have Nocturne kill the Diana. That's what I'm going to try, you know, like have my Arachnoid Horror challenge the Diana.
The full moon awakens the soul.
No one is safe.
We could use a bite. Our light grows brighter.
Sorry about that. So I guess they had a pill cascade. Too bad. Okay, I just need to settle down. We've been having some poor luck here, but just been trying to do like a million things this morning. I just need to relax, settle down. There's people doing some kind of construction or something like outside, like some like one of the neighbors is doing some kind of landscaping. It sounds like, or something. There's just loud drilling and everything out the window, and so the dogs are barking, and it's just, it's chaotic.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll play this Talking Shadow so that if they would pass for some reason.
Moonlight cloaks the land in silver.
Okay. I was kind of planning on having Miscall for the Elise, but I guess we're going to need some blockers, aren't we? This Nocturne's about to level up.
No more lies. I will be heard.
Terror is my domain.
Good morning, Dark Dragoon. Thank you so much. Oh, right there, the gem. I forgot about the gem. Yeah, I should love a Vile Feast. So both Diana and Nocturne do have Vulnerable, so maybe I can take them out. So just have to, you know, attack with like Wraithcaller and Mistwraith and try to take them out with both of those.
Your time will come. So
yeah, I should have Vile Feasted Diana first. So a Pale Cascade doesn't save either of the two champions. But it does that. That's like the card that we're missing is Pale Cascade. And this is what Cabo told me to do, and I just wanted to play the exact list that they were playing, but basically we should probably be playing just three Targon cards and just playing three Pill Cascades. Yeah, it's a great card. What a draw. Stalking Shadows, what a draw. Oh god, Stalking Shadows, it's Doom Beast? Are you kidding me? Their third Doom Beast. That's great. Man. Okay, playing against Arena Control. So as you can see, we have Targon in here. For this fifth and final game, I decided to change two of the spells. We're taking out, this hand looks pretty good. Actually, no, let's get rid of the Onlooker. Because they're, again, like these Shadow Isles Ezreal decks are just built on dealing one damage to things, and so I don't really want to have things that die to one damage. But anyway, we took out the Vile Feast and the Mistcall, those two spells that have looked pretty poor, and replace them with just the two Nightfall cards that are both amazing. With so playing Unspeakable Horror instead of Vile Feast, and playing Pale Cascade. So we have three Pale Cascades. So that could cause Wraithcaller to miss some. There's only three. Hopefully it doesn't. Cool. Yeah, Unspeakable Shadow Isles, the Pale Cascades, or the Targon. you know, just basically upgraded the quality of those two spells dramatically. I think that should be better for us.
Here comes the punchline.
We were just a little short on mana. Oh, I'm sorry, Michael.
I don't need a plan. Trouble coming at ya.
If we had one more mana, we could have double risen miss right there and then, you know, turn them into being 5 power so that we would trade with Vi. Alright, we miss again. I think it's going to be easier for them to kill the onlooker. There's more things that kill onlooker than kill... Yep. As far as, like, you know, us trading with Vi is concerned. So that's why I had the 3-2 challenge to Vi. I never thought it would have been possible to miss so many times, but I hadn't seen you do it. Yeah, we've been missing.
I try being polite.
We have been missing. We'll go with the Nocturne. Nope. At least it's not Ruination. This is just 2 extra damage than this would be. Probably better to do this. Yeah, this is not a very good atrocity matchup because of all their fast speed removal. So I'm not that confident in atrocity working. It looks like we just don't have an option. Though we have to go Pale Cascade into Atrocity now. Okay, well, they're tapped out, so that's good. There we go, see? We play Pale Cascade, and immediately Pale Cascade wins. GG. Perfect. Okay, so that was... that game went a little better. That went a little better, but there is a lot of power with the Mistwraiths. I'm honestly not that sold on, like, 4-mana Risen Myths, to be honest. Not, like, that sold on it, but... yeah, basically, I think that just gotta be playing Pale Cascade, Unspeakable Horror. These two cards are just way too good. And that can help us out quite a bit. So this deck has, yeah, like, the Stalking Shadows. Like, we missed multiple times with Stalking Shadows. And there's only 18 units in here. So, yeah, there's only 18 units. That's not very many. For, like, 18 followers to for Stalking Shadows. So I could definitely see, maybe the Unspeakable Horror should just be another follower, or the Risen Mist just be a different follower. I'm not sold that like 4 spell mana is worth a Mistwraith. Yeah, not sold on that. So could go, if you want to play Chronicler of Ruin, that could maybe be where you fit in Chronicler of Ruin. But again, that'd be like 12 regular units that cost, regular mana instead of this being spell mana. I'm not sure exactly what to do there. But I would prefer, the spells to be more in like the 12 to 14 range whenever you're playing Stalking Shadows. All right, but that's Nocturne Mistwraiths. So, no, the spider is good. I wouldn't drop a spider at all. But yeah, you say like two, just play 2 Risen Mist. Yeah, you could play 2. I don't really know what to play though instead. Like that's, I could definitely see. Like I said, like I want the spells. I just don't know what unit to play. Like I want the spell to be in like the 12 to 14 range. So yeah, if you say cut 1 Unspeakable Horror, cut 1 Risen Mist, I'm perfectly fine with that. I just don't know what unit to play. I do think it's probably like one in, like we start with like ones and twos. I would want a 1 or a 2 drop, like probably a 1 drop. I don't know if like Sinister Poro is any good. Like could this be Bark Beast? Like I'm not sure if this could be a Bark Beast deck. Because whatever it is, you want it to be Shadow Isles, because you just can't miss with Wraithcaller, so it's got to be Shadow Isles. So the best card to be playing would be Solari Soldier, but that's not an option. It's like all the best options to play are Targon. So that's what I don't know what to do with as far as units go. Hey, what's up, Nola Gold? No, it's not a Bark Beast deck. But all the best options are Targon. I mean, I guess like Warden's Prey or something. Because the thing is, like, there's already, like, too many, like, 3s and 4s, and, like, the other good options with Shadow Isles are, like, 3 plus mana, and I don't think you want anything, like, you just curve-wise, really need something else that costs, like, 1 or 2, particularly 1 would be really nice. Like, 2, we got a few options on 2 with Horror, Elise, Mistwraith already. So I guess it would be, I mean, just by process of elimination, you're basically looking at Sinister Poro, Warden's Prey and Bark Beast. Warden's Prey could do some blocking for you at the very least. Maybe it's just 2 Warden's Prey that does some blocking for you. And because the other reason why these 1 mana cards are important is because they turn on your Nightfall. They help enable the Nightfall stuff. Maybe I just play 2 Warden's Preys. That's probably what I'd do. Alright, anyway, that's Nocturne Mistwraiths. Those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there, and of course, feel free to leave those comments as well. I'd appreciate that. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.